All right, what's happening? Tell me what's happening. Band under sight. Possibly with people inside. I'm here today with a cat burglar and a fat man. Oh, there he is, walking in front of my shot again.
So there are actually workers on the site that are in there, no security patrolling. How long's the video last?
I don't know.
I'm not going to talk a whole lot. Just going to show you exactly what's up.
So, we're going to go through quietly, because we don't know if we're going to find anybody else in here. Oh, nice. There he is again, getting in the way of my fucking shot. So far there's just bits and bobs of furniture left around, plenty of broken glass and bits of shit. This would be Kathy Ford's office, of course. I think she went a bit batshit there. This is the sitting room, guys. It's a nice room, I'll be honest. Oh, well, that's been growing through for a while, haven't it? Lovely fireplace in here as well. This is the ladies' bedroom. I mean, you can clearly see some form of vandals have been in here. So it's a pool cave, snooker cave. Ceiling or somebody just pissed on the floor. Wouldn't surprise me either way. Oh, we got stains. Right under the stairs storage. Back outside. And a door that's got the handle on the inside. I wonder if that's an external door actually. So let's take a wander upstairs, see what we can see. Nice bit of decay going on. Gotta say, it's quite warm in here. As my teammate has just pointed out, it's fucking boiling. Ooh. So you can see through the windows. This is a massive place. We're here on the staircase, yeah, I'm gonna stay left. Guys, you'll be proud of me this time. It's the first time I'm wearing safety boots on an explorer. I've stood on one too many nails. So that's just straight back down the way we've come from. Slightly further along though. Offices up on this level. It's another big sitting room looking thing. Oh, nice. Very nice. Can't fault that. Can't fault that. Jesus. What can you smell?
Dead dog in
there. There's footprints on the bed or something.
Oh, fucking hell. Ooh, Jesus.
Can you cover that, isn't it?
Unless it just putrefied onto the bloody floor. Hold that door open. Now, is that the plumbing that's let go? Because that's animal footprints. And I don't think the dog would have had the thumbs to be opening this door. More bedrooms again. If I didn't say it earlier, this is a mental hospital. It was shut down a couple of years ago. It smells of rotten piss in there. I don't know, but either way, it's got another one of those hydro bath things in it. External door. Back up we go. Don't know why, but my focus is going a bit dodgy of late. Now, my focus has gone again, is it? Here we go. Right, pretty much. This is the sketchiest explorer I've ever done. Because we've got active CCTV inside, security lights, potentially sensors. We know there are security that do monitor the place. Although they've potentially got a little bit of a response time. And also, there's loads and loads of active buildings around this, car parks, people, all sorts of stuff. But yeah, sketchy as all fuck. But getting it done. What's happening? I'll tell you what's happening. I don't think we're alone in here. There's doors banging and other such things. And there's possibly, I heard maybe a bit of machinery or something in here. And Jordan, being a big fat fuck that he is, definitely walked in front of a fucking CCTV camera. So yeah, it's got signs in here which makes me think somebody's been in here doing something. So I don't know whether that was people emptying stuff. See, there's a CCTV camera up above me. What is that noise? Ooh. I would say it's the fire system. It's actually the server that's making the noise, which is madness. So I think we've got a little kitchen canteen area here.
Did you notice the ball valves
like
that?
No.
No way in?
No. Well, the server's on. Kitchen. Proper cuckoo's nest speaker system. That's banging. So there's another open door there that's banging. Makes me feel slightly better about things. Oh look, this is the nightmare corridor. Amazing. Yes. We've got an atmospheric door slamming, which is always good for a laugh. Got corridors off corridors. Do you see which way Fatty went? No. Oh, he's there. Forever in my shots.
This is cool.
Ooh. Like a breakout room, I would assume. We've got state-of-the-art machinery here for providing you with everything you'd ever need, including Kengo. Good old Kengo. We've got some like a lounge bar sort of seating.
Do you know what's quite freaky?
What's that, man?
Well, about half the time, you know, obviously the clock isn't working, but we're almost in the exact time that it says on the clock.
That just adds more credence to the fact that we died earlier and that this is all just a notion in our sick twisted minds. Yeah, that's true. So like onwards. Back into that break room. Don't leave it there, they've been moving some stuff. Some equipment, got a nice TV. Some room I missed. It's just corridors after corridors.
It's scary on this place, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I've never had doors though. There was a stairs as well back there.
There was a stairs.
What if you do the stairs first?
The money shot. Wow. Jesus, look at the architecture in here. They had a charity variety show, one would assume. And are these like makeshift rooms? Are they examination rooms? But look at this place. It's a bit of a random thought. But I'm noticing when filming in 4K that I don't seem to have the wide angle that I do when I'm filming in HD. Could just be me. Oh, standard piano. Oh, bloody complex Urbex, naturally. Dressing rooms, maybe. Hello? Bloody Claire from the Decay Mouse, isn't it? What you doing?
Sorry, mum.
Sunny day. But guys, there's just corridors off corridors leading to many different staircases. Madness. Another server box or router box?
Where we've been, where we haven't been. It's just literally trying to do all we can do.
I think that handle's a bit fucked. Yep.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, this is not a very well kept area. pigeons, haven't you? You've been in here. Pigeons in flight. The patient's rooms are going to be much of a match next. Yeah, pretty much the same thing going on so far. See if we can go until we find something a bit different. Kitchen area, washing machine area. This is one of few corridors that hasn't got a staircase at the end of it. Well, well, well. That's certainly noteworthy. Fascinating bit of graffiti down the end to the right.
Down the end to the right.
Yeah. So we've got a bit of tinsel going on, of course. So go and have a quick look in this interesting room. Now this is proper mental business, this is, isn't it? Painted as a face, naturally. Atmosphere. Who else remembers atmosphere? Leave a comment below. Speakers. Jeez. Paper towel dispenser has got a picture of a twine on it. I couldn't tell you why. Got some pall mall smokers going on in here. Bath. And staircase down. Now, I've been told a little surprise awaits in physiotherapy. So let's go and have a look. Bloody hell. I see what they mean. Got the old power jog, naturally. And Justin's locker. Relaxation room. Well, it's not very relaxing at the moment. It's just got upside down tables in it. Apologies for the focusing, guys. I don't know what's going on there. Here we have, we got lockers. The most unusual urinal I've seen today. I also apologize for the squeaking of my shoes. Oh my god, clothes. Oh, I don't know if it's going to be mad shit, but we got psychology department upstairs. Let's go and have a look. Let's go and have a look at the psychology department. See if we can find out Lynn Mad Murdoch. It's a reference for the older people amongst you. We've got an unsolvable force meeting an immovable object. and Karen. Well, you would offer a little bit of padded cells or something, yeah? Just rooms by the looks of it. Fucking very generic. Another corridor. Assistant psychologist. Assistant psychologist had a decent sized room. Hey guys, if you like corridors, this is the place to come. But I have been warned that the place does get vandalised. And also, as recently as yesterday, Jesus, fucking idiot. Speaking of vandals. So I was told that yesterday was about 10 men in their 20s, masked up with bats and hammers, and they're smashing it up. So you know, you've got to be prepared. Got to take precautions. That's all right. Security door. Peely paint door. Once again, another epic corridor shot. Right, we must have been down there, psychology and counselling services. A food hygiene raid and all that, canteen maybe. They're all canteen, we think. They're having a very good food hygiene raid and all that. Okay, so we're down now by the entrance to the hospital. Snack and tack, naturally. Rainbows of Cardiff. Oh, that's musty as fucking, yeah. Jesus. So we're in the corridor now, which is the main entrance to the hospital. Well, was the main entrance. It's a massive place, and obviously I've had to chop and change the footage around a bit because there's just so much for it to see. I don't want to be sitting there looking at empty rooms most of the time. Just trying to leave in the things you might want to see. Would that be admissions then? Cashiers. Why would you want cashiers? Are people paid a weekly wage in cash? Some sort of admin office. Severe asbestos inside and a security camera. So we'll have a look through the door. Here we are, that's the main entrance. There's another ward of the hospital, and over here we've got a smoking room. You can smoke in there, but certainly don't bring any drinks in. Staff room, kitchen, meeting room. Staff only. It's funny, it's a wonder if it's just a load of staff areas. Single rooms again. I've yet to find a padded room, a straitjacket, or any of that stereotypical mental hospital sort of business. But I shall keep looking. Film myself for a second, just because I haven't been. Alright, how are you doing? Well, we've been in here a while, we haven't been cold yet. Always a bonus. We're in the lounge room. There is a pool table. And I was quite amused. If you're a fan of the in-betweeners, then you'll understand this. The boy. Right then, guys. Thank you very much for joining me. Hopefully, join me again next time. Find out where we'll be. I don't know. So, wherever the wind takes me, innit?